and fiddling on their roof. Sounds crazy, no? But here in our little village of Anatevka, you might say every one of us is a fiddler on the roof. Trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? Well, we stay because Anatevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word. Tradition! Balance for many, many years. Here in Anatevka, we have traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to work, how to wear our clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered and wear a little prayer shawl. This shows our constant devotion to God. How did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know, but it's a tradition. And because of our traditions, everyone knows who he is, and what God expects him to do.
Day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers, and who has the right, as master of the house, to have the final word at home? The papas, the papas. Tradition.
Have a much larger circle. We don't bother them, and so far they don't bother us. Among ourselves, we get along perfectly well. Of course, there was the time when he sold him a horse but delivered a mule, but that's all settled now. Now we live in simple peace and harmony. It was a mule.
It was a horse.
It was a mule.
It was a horse.
It was a mule.
It was a horse.
It was a mule.
Traditions. Without our traditions, our lives would be as shaky as a fiddler on the roof. I had the little accident with the horse.
Tebbe, you didn't get the rabbi's order.
I know.
Tebbe, you forgot my order for the Sabbath. This is such bad news. Speaking of bad news, I have terrible news of the outside world.
What does it say?
It says in the village of Rzhenka, all the Jews were evicted, forced to leave their homes.
For what reason?
It doesn't say. Maybe the Tsar wanted their land, maybe a plague.
May the Tsar have his own personal plague.
Amen.
Why don't you ever bring us some good news?
I don't know. I only read it. It's an edict from the authorities.
May the authorities start ditching in places they cannot reach.
Amen!
Why do you curse them? What good does cursing do? You sit there, chatter, curse, and do nothing. You'll just chatter yourself into the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where are you from?
Yeah, I'm a student at the university.
Aha! The university! Is that where you learn to defy your elders?
That's where I learned there's more to life than just talk. You can't close your eyes to what's happening on the outside world.
Let them break their own heads about the outside world. I will not break mine.
He is right. As the good book says, if you spit in the air, it will land on your face.
That's nonsense. You can't close your eyes to what's happening in the outside world.
He is right.
He is right. And he is right. How can they both be right?
You know, you are also right.
He is right! He's still wet behind the ears! Good Sabbath, Tebbe!
Good Sabbath, Tebbe.
Good Sabbath.
Tebbe, the rabbi's order.
Yes, of course. So, you're a newcomer here, Reb...
Perchik.
As Abraham said, I am a stranger in a strange new land.
Moses said that.
Yes, forgive me. As King David puts it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses?
Yes. You know, for a man who had a slow tongue, he sure talked a lot.
And the cheese?
Yes, of course. Please, have a piece.
I have no money and I'm not a beggar.
It is my blessing to give to you.
Very well, for your sake.
Thank you, thank you. You know, it is no crime to be poor.
In this world, it's the rich who are criminals. One day, their wealth will be ours.
That's nice. If they would agree, I would agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People. Ordinary people.
Like you?
Like me.
Nonsense!
And until your golden day comes, Rev Perchik, how will you live?
By giving lessons to children. Do you have children?
I have 5 daughters.
5?
Daughters.
Girls are people. Girls should learn too.
A radical!
I can open their mind to great thoughts.
What kind of great thoughts?
Well, the Bible has many lessons for our days.
Well, I am a very poor man. Food for lessons? Good. Stay the Sabbath with us.
Hurry up, girls. We have a guest coming. Set up.
Mama, I took my finger.
found a good match for you, Zidol.
From your mouth to God's ears.
But Mama, why is she here now? It's almost the Sabbath.
Out, all of you. I want to talk to Yenta alone.
Oh, but Mama, the men she finds. The last one was so old, he was bald. He had no hair.
A poor girl without a dowry can't be particular. If you want hair, marry a monkey.
But Mama, even a poor girl has to look at her husband sometimes.
A husband is not to look at. A husband is to get.
But Mama, I'm not yet 20.
Shut up. I don't... Must you boast about your age? You'll tempt the evil eye. Out, all of you. There's work to be done before the Sabbath.
Gold, darling. I have such news for you. And not every day of the week news, no. But once in a lifetime news. Such diamonds, such jewels. I'll find a husband for every one of them. But you shouldn't be so picky, right? Of course, right. Because after all, even the worst husband, God forbid, is better than no husband, God forbid. Who should know better than me? Ever since my husband died, I've been a poor widow. All alone, no one to talk to, nothing to say to anyone. All I do at night is think of him, and even thinking of him gives me no pleasure. He never raised his voice.
Good afternoon. Is Zidol in the house?
She's busy. Come back later.
There's something I want to tell her.
Later.
What does a poor skinny tailor want with Zidol?
They've always been friends. They talk, they play.
Play? What do they play?
I don't know. They're children.
From such children come other children.
Matul is nothing. Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Ah, children. They are a blessing in your old age, but my errand, may he rest in peace, couldn't give me children. To tell you the truth, Golda, he hardly tried. But what's the use complaining? Other women enjoy complaining. Not Yenta. Not everyone in the world is a Yenta. So, I have to go home now to prepare my poor Sabbath meal. So, goodbye, Golden. It was a pleasure talking our hearts out to each other.
Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Oh, I'm losing my head. Someday it'll fall off all together. A horse will kick it in the mud and goodbye, Yenta. Of course, the news. It's about Laser Wolf, the butcher. A good man, a fine man. And I don't have to tell you he's well off, no?
Yes.
But he's lonely, the poor man. He's been a widower all these years, you understand? So to make it short, out of the whole town, he's cast his eye on Zidol.
My Zidol?
No, the Tsar Zidol. Of course you're Zidol.
Such a master, my Zidol. But Teve wants a learned man. He doesn't like Laser.
Good, so Laser won't marry him. He wants the daughter, not the father. Listen to me, Golda. You send Teve to him. Don't tell him what it's about. Let Laser discuss it himself. He'll win him over. He's a good man and a wealthy man. So you let me know how it went. But you don't have to thank me, Golda, because aside from my fee, which Laser will pay anyway, it gives me satisfaction to make people happy. True? Of course, true. So, goodbye, Golda, and you're welcome.
Goodbye, Yenta. Come, children, you must get ready for the Sabbath.
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches.
It might be someone wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And important.
Well off.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find. Catch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look for your book. Give me a perfect match.
The envy of all our sins.
only has one son. Why shouldn't I want the best?
Because you're just a poor girl from a poor family. So whatever Yenta brings, you'll take, right? Of course, right.
Too quiet up there? You just say to yourself, let's see, what kind of mischief can I play on my friend Tevya?
Aha, so you're finally here, my breadwinner.
I'll talk to you later.
So why are you late today?
His foot went lame.
Hurry up, the sun won't wait, and I have something important to tell you.
I still have some deliveries in the village.
You'll be late for the Sabbath.
I won't be late.
You'll be late.
I won't be late. I won't be late. If you ever stop talking, I won't be late.
And die from such a man.
Oh, dear Lord, you made many, many poor people. And I realize, of course,
it's no shame to be poor.
But it's no great honor either. So, what would have been so terrible if I had this small fortune?
If I was a rich man, yubba dibba dibba yubba dibba 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 dum, all day long I'd bitty bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Yubba dibba dibba yubba dibba 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 dum. If I were a bitty bitty rich, idle diddle 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 man, I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up and one even
coming down, and one more leading nowhere, just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks, but how can you? Walking just as noisily as they can, with each loud
yee-kee-yee-koo-yee-kah-yee-koo,
like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say he lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, yuppity-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-d I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a pretty, pretty rich, I'd old man. I'd see my wife, my golden, looking like a rich man's wife, with the proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in! Screaming at the servants day and night. The most important man in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise them, like a Solomon the wise. If you please, Reptavia, pardon me, Reptavia. Posing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. Yada da da, yada da da, yada da da da. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think. Really, no. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I left to sit in the synagogue and pray. Maybe have a seat by the eastern wall. And I'd discuss the holy books with the learned men. 7 hours every day. That would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, all day long I could have been long. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Lord, who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan? If I were a
daughters. This is my mwah. And this is my mwah.
And this is mine. And this is mine. And this is mine. And this is not mine. Patrick, this is Mortal Kombat.
So, you did us a favor and came home.
And this is also mine, Golde. Golde, this is Patrick. He is from Kiev. He will be staying the Sabbath with us. He is a teacher. Would you like lessons from him, children?
Yes, Papa.
I'm a very good teacher.
I heard the rabbi must praise himself has a congregation of one.
Your daughter has a quick and witty tongue.
Well, the wit she gets from me. As the good book says...
The good book can wait. Get washed.
The tongue she gets from her mother.
Motel, you're also eating with us? Of course. Another blessing. Zaito, the small table. Pava, the two chairs. Hurry, children. It's almost the Sabbath. Tevye, I want to talk to you.
Why should today be any different?
Tevye, I have something to say to you.
Motel, Yente was here.
I know, I saw her.
Well, if they decide on someone for me, it will be too late for us.
But I found someone who will sell me this new sewing machine. Maybe in a few weeks I'll have saved up.
Yes, Motel, but a few weeks might be too late.
Laser Wolf wants to see you.
The butcher? What about?
I don't know, only he says it's important.
Important? I have nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, I want you to talk to him.
If he's thinking about buying my new milk cow, he can forget it!
Tevye, I want you to talk to him. Tevye, I want you to talk to him!
What else can I do?
You can ask my father for my hand tonight.
Now? Why should he consider me now? I'm only a poor tailor.
And I'm only the daughter of a poor milkman. Just talk to him.
If your father says no, that's it. It's final.
Motel.
I'm just a poor tailor.
Yes, Motel, but even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness.
That's true.
Amen.
Amen. A man sends you a message. At least talk to him.
I don't want to.
Talk to him.
All right. After the Sabbath, I will talk to him.
All right. I'll talk to him.
Where is everyone?
Oh, I don't know, Papa.
Not now.
Hurry up, children. Hurry up. Not now. Children, we are lighting the candles. Yes, Motel.
Reptevye.
Yes, yes.
Reptevye.
Yes, well, Motel, what is it?
Good Sabbath, Reptevye.
Good Sabbath, good Sabbath. Hurry up, children.
Come, children.
Strengthen us, O Lord, and keep us from the strain.
Antivia. Come, have a seat.
Thank you.
Here, have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
How goes it with you, Lyptivia?
How should it go?
I suppose you're rich.
And you?
The same.
How's your brother-in-law in America?
He's doing well.
He wrote you?
No, not lately.
Oh, well, how do you know?
Well, if he was doing poorly, he would write.
Fine. So, Tevye, I'm sure you'd like to know the reason as to why I called you out here.
Oh, I know. But there's no use talking about it.
Tevye, I understand how you feel, but I mean, you will have a few more without her.
I see. Today you want one, tomorrow you may want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
Same as you would do with one.
Lyptivia, this is very important to me.
Why is it so important to you?
Well, frankly, because I'm lonely.
How is your little cow going to keep you company?
Little cow? Is that what you call her?
Well, that's what she is, no?
What are you talking about? Don't you know?
Of course I know what you're talking about. You're talking about my new milk cow. The one you want to buy from me.
A milk cow. A milk cow so I won't be lonely. No, no. I'm talking about your daughter. Your daughter Zeitel.
My daughter Zeitel?
Yes, your daughter Zeitel. I see her every Thursday at my butcher shop. She's made a very good impression on me. A very good impression. Lyptivia, I like her. What do you think? Why can't we just shake hands and call it to match? Huh? And I will be good to her. Lyptivia. I like her. Well, what do you think?
What do I think? I never really liked him. You can have a fine conversation if you're talking about kidneys and livers. On the other hand, not everyone has to be a scholar. And with a butcher, surely my daughter would never know hunger. He is a good man. He likes her. He will try to take care of her. What do I think? It's a match.
What? You agree?
I agree.
Oh, Tevye, you've made me a happy man.
Good.
Come, let's drink on it.
Oh, sure, why not? To you.
No, my friend, to you.
To the both of us.
To our agreement.
To our agreement. To our prosperity. To good health and happiness. And most important, to life, to life, Lehayim.
Lehayim, Lehayim, to life.
Here's to the father I try to be.
Here's to my pride to be.
Drink Lehayim, to life, Lehayim. Lehayim, Lehayim, to life.
Life has a way of confusing us,
blessing and bruising us.
Drink Lehayim, to life.
papa.
Your papa. You know, Lazarwolf, I've always wanted a son, but I wanted one who is a little younger than myself. All right. Have a good night.
Good night, Rotivia.
That congratulation ain't ordered, Tibia.
Oh. Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you.
I have some news I think I should tell you as a friend.
Yes, Your Honor.
I'm giving you this news because I like you.
Thank you, Your Honor.
You're honest and decent, even though you're a Jew.
Thank you. It is not every day a man gets a compliment like that. And the news?
We have received orders that sometime soon in this district is to have a little unofficial demonstration.
What? A pogrom here?
No. Just a little unofficial demonstration.
Little? How little?
Not too serious. So if an inspector comes through, he can see we did our duty. I don't know why there has to be this trouble between people, but I thought I should tell you.
Thank you, Your Honor. If I may say so, it is too bad that you are not a Jew.
That's what I like about you, Tevye. You are always joking. Congratulations again for your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Oh, about the other matter, it won't be too bad. I wouldn't worry.
Of course not. Did you have to send me news like that today of all days? I know, we are the chosen people. But once in a while, couldn't you choose somebody else? Anyway, thank you for sending a husband for my Zaito.
So, after Jacob had worked for Laban for 7 years, do you know what happened? He fooled him and gave him his ugly daughter, Leah, instead. So, to marry Rachel, he was forced to work another 7 years. As you see, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you can never trust an employer. Yes, that is the story of Jacob, if you interpret it correctly.
Is your papa up yet?
No, Mama.
Enough lessons. Back to the house. There's work to be done.
Go on, children. Another story tomorrow.
That was a very interesting lesson, Perchik.
Do you think so?
Yes, although I don't know if the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
Neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
My sisters talk too much.
What do you even know about him, other than he is the rabbi's son?
At least I know this. He has no strange ideas about turning the world upside down. Good day, Perchik.
You have wit, even some intelligence.
Thank you.
But, perhaps, what good is the brain? Without curiosity, it is a rusty tool. Good day.
We have an old custom here. A boy talks respectfully to a girl. But of course, that is too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our traditions. Everything is perfect. Nothing must change.
We like our ways.
Our ways are changing. In the city, boys and girls can be affectionate without a matchmaker's permission. They hold hands, even dance together. New dances, like this. I learned it in Kiev. Do you like it?
It's very nice.
There, you've just changed an old custom.
Yes, I mean, thank you. I mean, good day.
So, my prince is finally out of bed.
Oh, go away.
What happened last night besides you drinking like a peasant? Well, did you see Lady Wolf? What did he say? What did you say?
Where is Zaitel?
She's in the kitchen. Do you have news for me? What happened?
Patience, woman, patience. As the good book says, good news will stay and bad news will refuse to leave. Another saying goes,
"Who can die from such a man? What happened? How was it?"
Cha, woman, cha!
Are you still drunk or what?
Here she is! Saito, my lamb, come! You are to be congratulated! You are going to be married!
Married? What do you mean, Papa?
Laser Wolf has asked for your hand!
I knew it!
The butcher?
Dear God, I thank thee, I thank thee!
Why do you have to? What do you have to say, Saito?
What can she say?
Just let her say one word.
My Saito, a bride, a bride! May you grow old with him in fortune and honor. Not like Fru Masera, that first wife of Blazers. She was a bitter woman. May she rest in peace. Not like my Saito. And I must thank Yenta, my firstborn, a bride, a bride. I thank thee, I thank thee.
Well, Ava, huh?
Mazel tov, Saito.
Mazel tov, Saito. What kind of a mazel tov was that? And you, Red Perchik? Aren't you going to congratulate her?
Congratulations, Idol, for getting a rich man.
Again with the rich. What is wrong with being rich?
It's no reason to marry. It's the world's curse.
May the Lord smite me with it, and may I never recover. World's curse? My Idol knows that I mean her welfare. Am I right?
Yes, Papa.
There, you see?
I see. I see very well.
Well, Zaito, why are you so silent?
Well, Papa, it's
well,
just...
Well, tell me.
Papa, I don't want to marry him. I can't marry him. I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
Well, Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself as a servant. Just anything, Papa, please.
But we made an agreement, and between us, an agreement is an agreement.
But Papa, is that more important than I am? Please, I will be unhappy all my days. I don't want to marry him, Papa.
All right, I won't force you.
Oh, thank you, Papa.
It seems it was not ordained that you should have all the comforts of life.
Reptavia, may I speak to you?
Not now, Mato, not now.
But I would like to speak to you.
Later, Mato, later. I have problems.
That's why I want to speak to you. I think I can help.
Yes. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, Mato. Goodbye.
Papa, come on. Just listen to him, please.
All right, you have a tongue. Talk.
Reptavia, I hear you're arranging a match for Zidal.
Ah, so he also has ears.
Well, I have a match for Zidal.
What kind of a match?
A perfect fit. Like a glove. This match was made exactly to measure.
A perfect fit? Made to measure? Mortal! Stop talking like a tailor and tell me, who is it?
Please don't shout at me, Reptavia.
All right, I won't shout. Who is it?
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 It's me, myself.
It's him! Himself! Either he's crazy or he's out of his mind. You must be crazy, arranging a match for yourself. What are you, everything? The bridegroom, the matchmaker, the guests, all wrapped into one? I suppose you'll perform the ceremony as well.
Please don't shout, Reptavia. As for being my matchmaker, I know it's unusual.
Unusual? It's crazy!
Times are changing, Reptavia. The thing is, a year ago, Zylan and I gave each other our pledge that we would marry.
You gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa. We gave each other a pledge.
They gave each other a pledge? Unheard of! Absurd! They gave each other a pledge! Unthinkable. Where do you think we are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think we are? America? What do you think you're doing? You're a stitcher. You're nothing. Who do you think you are? King Solomon? This is not the way it is done. Not here. Not now. Some things I will not, I cannot allow. Tradition! Marriages must be arranged by the Papa. This should not be changed. Do I still have something to say about my daughter? Doesn't anyone have to ask a father?
Reptevia, I've wanted to ask you for some time now, but first I wanted to save up enough for my own sewing machine.
Otto, stop talking nonsense. You are just a poor tailor.
That's true, Reptevia, but even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. I promise you, your daughter will not starve.
Ah, he is beginning to talk like a man. On the other hand, what kind of a match would that be with a poor tailor? On the other hand, he is an honest, hard worker. On the other hand, he has absolutely nothing. On the other hand, things could not get worse for him, only better. They gave each other a pledge, unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge, unthinkable. But look at my daughter's eyes. She loves him. She wants him. And look at my daughter's face. So hopeful. Tradition! Well, children, when shall we make the wedding?
Thank you, Papa, thank you.
Oh, Reptevia, you won't be sorry, you won't be sorry.
I won't be sorry? I'm sorry already.
Oh, but thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa.
All right, all right.
They gave each other a pledge. Golden, what am I going to tell Golden?
It was a miracle! Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles. God took a Daniel once again. Stood by side and miracle of miracles led him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles. I was afraid that God would frown. But like he did so long ago in Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. Softened Pharaoh's heart. That was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one I thought would never be. God has made a man. A miracle. God gave us manna in the wilderness. That was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one I thought could never. God has given you to me.
Good day.
Hello, Sarah.
Mazel tov, Hava, mazel tov.
Soon it'll be you. Give my best wish to Zizel.
I will.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Mazel tov! Mazel tov! Mazel tov!
Stop it!
What's wrong with you, Fierka?
Just stop it.
We're just having a little fun, Fierka.
Goodbye, Sasha. I said goodbye. I'm sorry about that. They mean no harm.
Don't they? Is there something you want?
Yes, I'd like to talk to you.
I'd rather not.
Why? Because I am not a Jew. Do you feel about me the same way they do about you?
But what do you know about me anyways, huh? I'm a pleasant fellow, charming, honest, ambitious, quite bright, and very modest. Go ahead. Take this book, and after you've returned it, we can talk about it for a while. Then we can talk about life, how we feel about things. Here.
Thank you.
Good day, Hub.
Good day, Fiesta.
What am I going to tell Golda?
Was terrible.
All right. In the beginning, we were having a celebration of some kind. Everyone we knew was there. All our beloved departed. Before that was your great uncle Mordecai. Yes, yes, he was there. And in walks Grandmother Zeitel. May she rest in peace.
Grandmother Zeitel? How did she look?
Well, for a woman who's been dead 30 years, she looks very good. Naturally.
Blessing on your head.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
To see your daughter wed.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
And such a son-in-law, like no one ever saw. The tailor motel comes on.
Motel?
A worthy boy is he.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
A pious family.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
They named him after my dear uncle.
She must have heard wrong. She meant a butcher.
I'll tell her.
Go.
You must have heard wrong, Grandma. There's no tailor. You mean the butcher, Grandma, by the name of Laser Wolf.
We made a bargain with the butcher.
We announced it, Grandma, to our neighbors. We made a bargain, Grandma, with the butcher Laser Wolf.
Thank you.
such a dark and horrible dream, and it was brought on because you went to see that butcher. Tevye, if my grandmother Zaitel, may she rest in peace, took the trouble to come from the other world to tell us about the tailor, all I can say that's for the best.
But
it couldn't possibly be any better.
Hold it.
Amen.
Amen.
Our little story here will be taking a 15-minute break. A man has to get ready for his wedding, no? I'm really looking forward to this. I sure hope nothing goes wrong with it. Nah, that's ridiculous. I mean, we drank on it, no? Feel free to roam about as you please. Oh, I hear there's some Russians in the social hall selling some frozen treats for some senior trip. I don't know why they'd want to send a bunch of old people somewhere, but eh, what do I know? Remember to be back here in 15 minutes. L'chaim!
Together, just like two language you hear.
comrades, Martha and Zaitel. May they live together to a ripe old age. Amen.
Amen.
Ah, and here is our rabbi. May he be with us for many, many years.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, I would like to introduce the gifts that the parents of the bride have brought for the newlywed couple. A feather bed! A pair of goose pillows! And a pair of candlesticks. Now, let us not forget our friends and family who have lived in pain and poverty and hardship, and who have died in pain and poverty and hardship. But enough tears! Let us be merry like our good friend Laser Wolf, who has everything in the world except a bride. But he has no ill feelings. In fact, he has a gift for the newlyweds. Come, Laser Wolf.
Yes, yes, it is as he said. I have no ill feelings. What's done is done. I'm giving the newlyweds 5 chickens, one for the first 5 Sabbaths of their wedded life.
You're a decent man, Laser Wolf. And on behalf of my daughter and her new husband, I accept your gift. There is a famous saying that...
Rib-tibia, I am not marrying your daughter. I don't have to listen to your sayings.
He would listen.
Oh, why should I listen to you? A man who breaks an agreement. I have a right to talk.
What right? It is not your wedding.
He should have been.
Well, it's not. Thank goodness.
He shamed me. In front of the whole village, he shamed me.
Can I say something?
I say. Let's settle down.
All right. We all heard the words of the rabbi. Let's settle down. Now, I'd like to sing a little song.
You can keep your disease chicken!
You leave my chickens out of this! We had a bargain!
The terms were not settled!
We drank on it!
It wasn't settled!
Once a butcher, always a butcher. Once a liar, always a liar!
Sit down.
Those happen to be my chickens. Quiet. What's all the screaming about? They drank on it. An agreement. A sign. It's all nonsense. Mato and Zaito wanted to marry each other. Why not? They love each other.
Love?
He's a radical! So.
What are you doing?
Who will dance with me?
It's a sin!
No.
It's no sin to dance.
Go with the girl?
Yes, with the girl. Oh, this is what comes of entertaining a wild man.
He's not a wild man. His ideas are a little different, but...
Perch. Ha! It's a sin!
It's not a sin. Ask the rabbi. Go on, ask him. Well, rabbi?
Dancing? Well, it's not exactly forbidden, but...
There you go! It's not forbidden!
And it's no sin. So, who will dance with me?
No.
Play the music.
I can see she's dancing with the man.
friend Tevye. But the orders are for tonight, for the whole village.
No!
What are they doing?
No!
What did they do, Sylvia?
I'm truly sorry, you understand?
Of course!
Come.
Bring him to the house.
What are you all standing around for? Clean up! Clean up! Troubles, troubles. That's all you hear from me, right? But who are we, simple people, supposed to take our troubles to? You know, sometimes I wonder, who do you take your troubles to? Ah. Anyway, Malto and Zaitel have been married for some time now. And they're as poor as squirrels in winter. But they're so happy they don't realize how miserable they are. Molto keeps talking about the new sewing machine. I know you are very busy with wars, revolutions, plagues, famines, all those little things that bring people back to you. But couldn't you get him his new machine? Oh, and while you're in the neighborhood, my horse is late. Am I bothering you? I'm sorry. As the good book says, why am I telling you what the good book says?
So you must go away?
Yes. Yes, tomorrow morning.
Hello?
No, with a few friends. I will be joining others.
Where?
In the city. There are some things I cannot tell even you.
I see.
Please don't be upset.
Why should I be upset? If you must go, you must.
I do have to leave here.
So you told me.
There will be great changes, tremendous changes, but they cannot happen themselves.
So you think you personally must?
Not only me, many people, Jews, Gentiles, many people hate what's going on. Don't you understand?
Understand, of course. You want to leave, then goodbye.
Wait. I have work to do, the greatest work a man can do. Don't you understand?
Yes, Persian.
Wait, there's a question I wish to discuss with you.
Yes?
It's a political question.
What is it?
It's the question of marriage.
Is this a political question?
Well, yes. Like everything else, the relationship between a man and a woman are found on a socioeconomic base. Marriage is found on common beliefs and a common attitude and philosophy towards society.
And affection?
Well, yes. When two people face the world with such unity and solidarity.
And affection?
Well, yes, that is also important, but I am in favor of such a socioeconomic relationship.
I think you were asking me to marry you.
In a theoretical sense, yes, I am.
I was hoping you were.
I'm very happy. Very, very happy.
Oh, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Reb Tevye. I have some bad news.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. What is it?
I must leave here.
When?
Tomorrow morning.
We will all miss you, Perchik.
But I also have some good news.
Good?
You can congratulate me.
Congratulations! What for?
We're getting engaged.
Engaged?
Yes, Papa, we're engaged.
Oh, no, you're not. I get it. You like him and he likes you. But you are going away and you are staying here. So goodbye, have a nice trip, and my answer is no.
But Papa, you don't understand.
Oh, I understand. I gave my permission to Moto and Zaito, so now you feel you also have the rights. I'm sorry, Perchik. I like you. But you're going away. Have a nice trip, and my answer is no.
You don't understand, Papa.
Are you not listening to me? I said no!
Reb Tevye, we're not asking for permission, but for your blessing. We are getting married.
Well, they are not asking for my permission?
But we would like your blessing, Papa.
I can't believe my own ears. My blessing? For what? For going over my head? Impossible. At least with Zaito and Mottel, they asked me. They begged me. But now if I like it or not, you'll marry him. What do you want from me? Go on, be wed. Tear out my beard and uncover my head. Tradition! The man tells me he is going to marry you. He doesn't ask me. He tells me. But first he abandons you.
He's not abandoning me, Papa.
As soon as I can, I'll send for her and marry her. I love her.
Love? It's a new style. On the other hand, our old ways were new once, weren't they? On the other hand, they decided without their parents, without a matchmaker. On the other hand, did Adam and Eve have a matchmaker? Ah, yes, they did. It seems these two have the same one. They're going over my head. Unheard of, absurd. And for this they want my blessing? Unthinkable. But look at my daughter's face. She loves him. Tradition! Well, children, I've decided to give you my blessing and my permission.
Oh, thank you, Papa.
What else could I do?
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa. Oh, what am I going to tell your mother? Another dream?
Perhaps if you tell her I'm going to visit a rich uncle.
Perchik, please. I can handle my own wife. Golden! 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 Mm. Hello, Golden.
Have some soup.
Golden, I have something very important to tell you.
Have the soup, it's warm.
I just met with the Perchik and Ho.
Well?
Well, they seem to be very fond of each other.
So, what do you mean?
So, I decided to give them my permission to become engaged. I'll leave later.
What? Just like that, without even asking me?
Who asks you? I am the papa.
Who is he? A pauper. He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
Huh?
I hear he has a rich uncle.
A rich uncle.
Golden. He's a good man. I like him. He's a little crazy. But I like him. And what's more important, Hodel likes him. Hodel loves him. So what can we do? It's a new world. A new world. Love. Hodel, do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
Inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
No. Golden, I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
You're a fool.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you?
What?
For 25 years, washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children, milked your cow. After 25 years, why talk about love right now?
The first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we would learn to love each other. And now I'm asking, Golden. It's all right. You'll just have to wait a little while. Is he in bad trouble, this hero of yours? Arrested, convicted?
Yes, but he did nothing wrong. He cares nothing for himself. Everything he does is for other people.
Yes, but if he did nothing wrong, why would he be in trouble?
Papa, how could you say that? What wrongs did Joseph do, and Abraham, and Moses? And they had troubles.
Yes, well. But why won't you tell me? Where is this Joseph of yours now?
It is far, Papa. Terribly far. He's in a settlement in Siberia.
Siberia? He asks you to leave your father and your mother and join him in that frozen wasteland there?
He didn't ask me to go. I want to go. I don't want him to be alone. I want to help him in his work. How can I hope to make you understand why I do what I do? Why I must travel to a distant land, far from the home I love? Once I was happily content to be as I was, where I was. Close to the people who are close to me, here in the home I love. Who could see that a man would come who would change the shape of my dreams? Helpless now I stand with him, watching older dreams grow dim. There where my heart is settled long ago, I must go. Who could imagine I'd be wandering so far from the home I love? Yet there with my love, I
be in that wilderness to perform the ceremony.
Papa, I promise you, we will be married under a canopy.
Yes, yes. No doubt one or two rabbi may have been arrested as well.
Papa, God alone knows when we shall see each other again.
Then we shall leave it into his hands. Take care of her. See that she dresses warm.
What is the news of the outside world?
Terrible, Rabbi.
Then don't tell me. If I want bad news, I'll read about Noah and the flood. Now, come, Avram. Surely there must be something good going on somewhere. Can't you buy papers that print about those things?
It's not my fault. I only read it.
Rabbi, did you hear the news?
More bad news.
No, good news. At Meltel's and Zaytel's, a new arrival.
A new arrival at Meltel's?
We just heard the good news. Mazel tov.
Thank you very much. It's a nice thing.
Yes, it is. What is it?
It's a sewing machine. You can work twice as fast.
Oh, you got it!
I got it!
It's beautiful!
I know!
Have you tried it yet?
Look!
Oh, it's beautiful!
I know, in less than a minute. See how close and even the stitches are?
Beautiful bottle!
I know. From now on, my clothes will be perfect. Made by machine. No more handmade clothes.
Look, Mama, look. Oh, Mazel Tov, Mottel.
The rabbi. Rabbi, is there a blessing for a sewing machine?
There is a blessing for everything. Amen.
Amen.
That's your new arrival? What is it? A boy or a girl?
Well put.
Well, Mottel, I never thought you'd amount to anything. But look at you. A wife, a baby, and a sewing machine. You're a person!
Look, I'll show you how it works.
Go, children.
First, you put the cloth in like this. It's an amazing thing. You work it with your foot and your hand.
Oh!
Father is coming. Let me talk to him. Let me tell him about it.
No, that would be the worst thing, I'm sure.
But let me try.
No, I'll talk to him. I promise.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
It's a cold day, isn't it? Mm. Good afternoon, sir. Good day.
Good day. What were you and he talking about?
Nothing. We were just talking.
Good.
Papa, Fitka and I, we've known each other for a long time.
Papa, I would be much happier if you and he would remain friends from a distance. You must not forget who you are and who that man is.
He has a name, Papa.
Of course, all creatures have a name.
Fietka is not a creature, Papa. Fietka is a man.
And who says he is not? He is just a different kind of man. As a good book says, each shall seek his own kind. In other words, a bird may love a fish, but where would they build a home together?
The world is changing, Papa.
No, Hava. Some things for us do not change. Some things will never change.
We don't feel that way.
We?
Fiedka and I, we want to be married.
What? Are you out of your mind? Don't you know what that means? Marrying outside of the faith?
But Papa.
No, never talk about it again. Never speak of him again. Never see him again. Do you understand me?
I understand you, Papa. But at least listen to me. Papa, I beg you to accept us.
Accept them? How can I accept them? How can I deny everything I believe in? On the other hand, how can I deny my own daughter? On the other hand, how can I deny my people, my faith? On the other hand, no, there is no other hand.
But Papa.
No, Mama,
Papa,
no.
Papa, please.
No.
Papa, listen. Papa. Papa.
Mama, is Rip Tevye in the house?
He's inside.
Lately?
No, not lately. Why?
There have been some rumors. We thought, since you knew him so well, maybe he would have told you what is true and what is not.
Rumors? What kind of rumors?
Quiet. Talk, Abram.
Someone in Zolotin selling edicts from St. Petersburg.
Welcome, Your Honor. What is the good news in the world today?
I see that you have company.
Yes. They are my friends.
It is as well. What I have to say is for dears, years also. How much time do you need to sell your house and household goods?
Why should I sell my house? Is it in anyone's way?
I came to tell you you have to leave Anatevka.
How did I come to deserve such an honor?
Not just you, of course, but all of you.
But this little corner of the world has always been our home. Why should we leave?
You have 3 days to leave.
Just like that, a piece of paper and get thee out.
We should unite with the people of Zolotin. Maybe they have a plan.
We should defend ourselves.
An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
Yes, and the whole world will be blind and toothless.
Rabbi, we've been waiting for the Messiah all our lives. Wouldn't this be a good time for him to come?
Well, we'll have to wait for him someplace else. For now, we should start packing.
Well, Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
After all, it's just a place.
What do we leave? Nothing much. Only Anatevka. Anatevka.
Where else could Sabbath be?
Come, Golda. We have to leave.
Leave? It sounds so easy.
We will all be together soon, you'll see. Moto, Zaito, baby, they will come too. This Moto is a person.
And Hodl and Herchik, when will we see them again?
Will we see them every Sabbath, visiting from Siberia? You know what she writes. He sits in prison, she works. But soon, he will be free. And together, they will turn the world upside down. She couldn't be happier. The other children, they will come with us.
Not all.
Oh! Come, Golde.
I have to sweep first. Clean up.
Sweep?
Yes, I don't want to leave a dirty house.
Tevye, I'm on my way.
Oh, where are you going?
To Chicago in America.
Chicago, America. I am going to New York, America. You and I, we will be neighbors.
Yes, my wife, Flumicera, may she rest in peace, has a brother there.
Ah, that's nice.
I hate him. But a relative is a relative.
Very true, yes. Goodbye, Razor Wolf.
Goodbye, Reb Tevye.
Papa, we came to say goodbye. We are also leaving this place. We are going to Macau.
We cannot stay among people who would do such things to others.
We wanted you to know that. Goodbye, Papa.
Mama.
Come, Hava.
Goodbye, Hava.
And Fiedka.
And God be with you.
And God be with you. If you would like, you could write to us from America, please.
We are staying with Uncle Avram.
Yes, Mama.
Come, children. We have to leave.
Where are we, Papa?
We are staying with Uncle Avram.
Yes, Mama.
We are staying with Uncle Avram. We are staying with Uncle Avram. The whole world has to know our business.
Stop yelling and finish packing. We have a long way to go.
Do not need your advice. Zaito, don't forget the baby. Work hard, Motul. And come, see us soon.
I will, Papa. I'll work hard.
Come, children. Let's go. more question for you guys. Do you guys think it was a horse? A horse, right guys? Yeah, a horse. Or was it a mule?
It was a horse.
Horse.
Mule.
Horse.
Mule.
Horse.